हेलो गाइस, स्टैंडर्ड 6 चैप्टर नंबर 16 एयर अराउंड अस। लेट्स सॉल्व एक्सरसाइज। द फर्स्ट एमसीक्यू इज द परसेंटेज ऑफ ऑक्सीजन इन द एयर इज 21%। सेकंड, द गैस दैट मेक्स अप द मेजर पोर्शन ऑफ एयर इट इज नाइट्रोजन। थर्ड, ड्यूरिंग फोटोसिंथेसिस trees produces oxygen. Which of this is a greenhouse gas? So it is carbon dioxide. Which of this is a greenhouse gas? It was carbon dioxide. Fifth one, which of this is not an air pollutant? So it is nitrogen. Question 6. Fish breathe oxygen dissolved in water through their gills. 7. The air we breathe in is contained in the, so answer is troposphere. 8. Soil air is the air present in the space in soil. Small carbon footprint will. Make our fossil fuel reserves last longer. Put less carbon dioxide into the air. Look after our climate and weather. So answer is all of this. Fill in the blanks with the correct word. So first one, the gas that supports burning is oxygen. Second, this is an air pollutant. The answer is smoke. Third, if we add more greenhouse gases in the atmosphere, we will cause warmer weather. The layer of air that surrounds the earth is known as atmosphere. The ozone layer blocks the harmful ultraviolet rays from sun. Okay guys, now turn your page to examples. Question number 1. Two gases in the air. So it is nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide. These all are the gases. Write down any two. Second, particulate matter. So it is pollen, smoke. Third one, eco-friendly vehicles. It is CNG cylindrical vehicle, cylinder vehicles and electric vehicles. Air pollutants. So it is oxides of sulfur and carbon, dust. Now, give one word. So first one, a gas that supports burning. It is oxygen. Second, the trapping of heat in the earth atmosphere. So it is greenhouse effect. Third one, the gas that is useful for the growth of plants. It is nitrogen. Four, the breathing organ in fish. It is gills. Fifth, the harmful rays of the sun, it is ultraviolet rays. First short question, what is the percentage of carbon dioxide in the air? So guys, here section 1 students will write in fair notebook, but section 2 short question and long questions only, and with distinguish students will write in the fair notebook. So first question is, what is the percentage of carbon dioxide in the air? It is 0.04%. Second, where does the bad ozone come from? It is a result of car exhaust fumes, factory smoke, and it is a pollutant. Third one, what is the soil air and whom is it useful for? In the soil, in the earth, there is free space and pores, and the air present in this spaces is known as the soil air. Underground animals use the soil and soil for the breathing purposes. Why do earthworm comes out from the ground during the rain? Because rainwater will fill the holes, pores fill the space which is in the soil. That's why they need to breathe. That's why they comes out of the soil. Fifth, how do dolphins breathe? So after every 15 minutes, dolphins comes out to the surface of water and breathe for a few minutes, and they goes inside the water. How do mangrove plants breathe? So tip of the roots comes out from the water surface and they breathe. Now ozone layer and ground level ozone. So ozone that allows the sun rays to enter the earth atmosphere but block harmful ultraviolet rays of the sun from damaging things on the earth's surface. While ground level ozone, caused due to the exhaust fumes, factory smoke and other pollutant gases, right? Now write down the distinguish between the respiration and photosynthesis. Third one, oxygen available to organisms living in the soil and oxygen available to organisms living in water. So you can write from the textbook this answer. Now long question 1, draw describe the oxygen cycle. It is already given in textbook. Then write down importance of carbon dioxide. It is second question. Third one, which of our activities put too much carbon dioxide into air? It is already given in textbook. Fourth question, where does the moisture from wet clothes go when we dry them? It is given in the first or second page in the chapter. What are the ways in which air is useful? So this is given on the last page of the textbook.